Welcome back to Anime News Network. We are back with our Saturday AM series. This time we're joined by underground artist and creator JR DeBard. How you doing, my man?
Doing all right. It's great to be here.
Hey, thanks for coming, man. I'm looking forward to it as well. So tell us a little bit about Underground, what the story is about.
Underground follows a biracial character like myself. He's a half black, half Korean. He does Taekwondo and he fights in basically New York City's underground fight scene, seeking prestige because his father, Mo Hwang, is like a nationally renowned Korean kickboxer. So he seeks to become a champion underground to show that he's capable of the same, if not more, of what his father is.
That's awesome. And the dynamic between the brothers is really cool. Did you take Taekwondo when you were younger?
I did. I'm a second degree black belt. Apart from Taekwondo, I've taken a lot of other martial arts that all will come into play in Underground and have been studying even more as I go along, such as Hapkido. I've been studying Muay Thai. I even do this Korean sword martial art called Kumyeto. One of the things I want to incorporate into Underground is like a lot of different martial arts to show how culture within those arts, you know, can be diverse and how it can all come into play with all these different arts clashing with each other and these different characters. It's going to be real cool.
I think we can both confidently say martial arts anime is top notch.
Definitely. I mean, Hajime no Ippo is one of my favorites. I love Baki. I read Shamo. Whenever there's a martial arts manga, I'm going to read it.
What inspired the brotherly rivalry between Elijah and Kareem?
One of the things I wanted to incorporate between the two was this aspect of sport versus tradition. Whereas Kareem's, you know, the more competitive and violent character who fights underground, Elijah's more stoked in the tradition of Taekwondo, and their father, I don't want to spoil too much, but their father sort of sits on the fence between the two, being someone who competed in sports and due to an incident embraced more of the tradition and started a school in New York. So it's really their father that causes them to sort of clash a lot. But at the same time, during this first, I'm going to call it Dojang arc, you see that a bit of that competitive spirit also plays into Elijah. And as the story goes on, a bit of that tradition is also going to come and meet Kareem.
Yeah. And what I really like about it is they meet up like super quick in the beginning, and the fight starts in like the third issue. I mean, it starts out quick. Tell me a little bit about what made you decide to have them start fighting so quickly and start displaying their martial arts so quick, because generally you'll build up to something like that, but these brothers are already duking it out.
I figured to take it in reverse was almost it was a better way to sort of get people to really, you know, get in on all the action and see through their fight what is actually going on between the two, as opposed to setting everything up before the fight. You see a lot in the combat and choreography, just the relationship between the two characters. I think it's possible to really tell a story with the fight, as opposed to having the story and then the fight and then story.
Yeah, you have this like aggression on Kareem's side, and then Elijah's got this more kind of spiritual feel to him. How did the fighting scene in New York, like the martial arts, Taekwondo, how did that influence this series?
Good question. Well, a lot of it's really influenced from my own personal background. I took Taekwondo when I was in New York City, and then I moved upstate and took Taekwondo up here. A lot of, I guess, what really influenced it so much was I wanted to give the story an urban setting, a modern urban setting, but have like the feel of those like kung fu martial arts movies, you know, you got like Karate Kid, Ip Man, anything with Jackie Chan, that kind of stuff. Because, you know, I watched all those movies and I thought, hey, I can take this and put it into a New York setting with a biracial character and show that, you know, these stories have a place within, you know, a diverse storytelling world.
Yeah, and I like all the different martial arts that you were describing that you're taking, because it seems like they're going to be put into the series. Now, let me ask you, I see that it starts out with Taekwondo. Is there plan to expand into like Muay Thai and Jiu-Jitsu, other martial arts?
Oh, definitely. In issue 9 of PM, there was revealed a character who has a wrestling background. It's actually his art is inspired by both traditional wrestling and the professional wrestling you see on TV. So he is like a bit of a showboat. And that's all going to come into play. Like, his martial art is going to clash with Kareem's we see. So it's going to be sort of like this Taekwondo versus wrestling sort of fight, and how wrestling sort of exposes Taekwondo's weaknesses and how Karim has to sort of overcome that.
Man, that sounds like it's going to be awesome. I can't wait to see some wrestling versus Taekwondo.
Definitely. I can't wait to draw it.
I have one more question for you. What made you decide to go with making this series seinen instead of just making it shonen?
I thought it'd be a cool spin, really. The setting of, you know, an underground fight scene sort of lends itself more to, I think, a greater range of styles, considering with traditional MMA sport, there is kind of like a meta that you have to fit into, considering the rules and how it works. But in a place where there is no rules, you can have, you know, several different styles interact with several different ways, and it lends itself more to a more mature story. I made Underground to sort of be a seinen, but I also feel as though seinen is kind of the only place it could really fit.
Gotcha. I mean, yeah, because you were right, they go into just like all these different fighting styles. It's a little hard to capture some, and especially some of the maturity in shonen. So well done.
Thank you.
Well, hey, JR, thank you so much for joining me today. Guys, be sure to check out Underground on the Saturday AM app and on the Saturday AM website. There's more to come. And this one is actually in their Saturday PM edition, where you will find more seinen stories. So be sure to check that out, everybody. Thanks for joining us, JR.
Thanks for having me.